one of my favorite memories from shooting Jurassic Park, it was my birthday. I turned 9 while I was shooting it. And in one of the scenes, I'm being chased by one of the raptors into the freezer. I'm trying to evade him. So I'm supposed to move left, and the guy who's pushing the dinosaurs on wheels supposed to move right. So that's the way it was set up. It's fine, great. So we must do it like 10, 15 times. It just took forever. On one of the last takes, I go left, I turn around, and the dinosaur's coming right at me, and I just get nailed in the head by one of the claws. And Steven Spielberg chose that moment for the entire crew to sing happy birthday to me. But that wasn't the end. Right after that, as I'm dizzy and I'm getting up, Steven asked me if I can do just one more, just like a director. I met Steven Spielberg on the set of another film I did called Radio Flyer. And he was very good friends with that director, and so he would come around, and he was actually looking at me for another role for the movie that he did, Hook. But I didn't end up doing that one. I did Jurassic Park instead, and at the time, I just thought that he was some nice guy who wanted me to be in movies. I had no idea about anything that he had done. But definitely, now that I look back at it, I see that, you know, I really worked with, you know, maybe the best director in Hollywood. I always loved going to movies, even as a kid. But when I was a kid, it was usually my grandma who took me. And whenever we went and saw a movie, it would always be a Sunday matinee. And we would get there at least 30 minutes to 45 minutes before the movie actually started. So my brother and I would just be waiting there, just saying, how much more time, Grandma? How much more time? And it was always 10 minutes. But finally, the movie started, and the first one I really remember is the original Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie. Me and my brother went and saw that, and it was an empty theater, and we got up in the aisles and just started doing all of the karate moves that they were doing, and that was probably the first real memory I have of going to see a movie. I'm a huge baseball fan. If there was any one character that I could be from any movie I've ever seen, it would be Roy Hobbs in The Natural. One of Robert Redford's just greatest roles. If I could get the game-winning home run in the pennant race for the New York Knights, that would be it for me. My favorite film, without a doubt, is It's a Wonderful Life. And maybe that's a little cliche, but not so much for, I think, my generation. I don't know too many of my friends who would consider that their favorite film. But it's a real actor's movie. Jimmy Stewart, there's nobody better. I was in love with Donna Reed. I still am. I got to see it at the Arrow in Santa Monica. It was playing for Christmas, and I went just before Christmas, and it hit me just as much as it always does. There's so much that I love about It's a Wonderful Life. Probably the most is that, one, it's so nostalgic for me. It brings back my childhood, my family, us all sitting around and watching it during Christmas. But also, I just think it's the most perfectly constructed film, and it has great redemption, and it's so simple but so complex, and boy, it's that last line that always gets me, the one that the brother says to my big brother George, the richest man in town. If I could have one line ever, it would be that line and that part. I love it.